We're back. This time we're taking a look at the month 2 OP for the Resistance is Futile. And we'll get right in and take a look. First thing we have here is our resource. This is a participation prize just for showing up. This month we get the Advanced Targeting System. This is our reference card for the Advanced Targeting System. 5 points. At the start of the game, after the Gather Forces step, place your Advanced Targeting Systems card beside your ship cards. All ships in your fleet can acquire and maintain up to 2 target locks. Each target lock requires a separate action to acquire. Note you cannot acquire 2 target locks in the same round. Each target lock must be on a different ship. You can acquire 2 target locks on the same ship. During the activation phase, a locking ship that has already maintained 2 locks may remove one of its pair and acquire a different target lock. The ship may spend 2 target locks in the same combat phase if possible. All other normal rules apply to both target locks. On the back, we have our rules for resources. Then we have our reference card or reminder card for advanced targeting systems. Some people use these, some don't. On the newer ones, they actually printed them right on the back of the other card. This one's kind of an interesting one. 5 points is pretty reasonable, and with some of the better resources getting cycled out of rotation, this one might see some use. Being able to get 2 target locks means that you get a little more variety in what your choices to shoot at are. Normally, you get a target lock. Not a lot of people use torpedoes or secondary weapons. Most of the time, it's for that reroll. And then you might not necessarily be in the fire arc to shoot at the guy you target locked in the next turn or whenever you're ready to make that attack. Being able to get a second target lock on a second target, now you have 2 different options in which you can shoot at. Chances are one of the 2 are going to be in your fire arc. You're going to get that reroll and be able to actually make use out of that target lock. Especially useful with things like the Romulan Tactical Officer, who lets you get that additional reroll. So now you're getting the reroll from the target lock and an extra reroll on top of that. And you have multiple targets to choose from. Definitely useful. To a lesser extent, there are some ships out there now that get bonuses and things for firing torpedoes and things like that, making torpedo boats somewhat useful. You also have things like the Gorportus that doesn't lose its target lock when it's fired. It's kind of interesting in that respect, is you get to keep both target locks and you get to keep having multiple targets to choose from. So there's a lot of uses out there for this. As your only resource, not so sure. In home games, we usually give you up to so many points worth of resources, or for every 100 or so points of your fleet, you get an extra resource, things like that. So a lot of house rules where you can run multiples, definitely see this one getting used. But it still has its uses in a normal OP environment, especially, like I said, with some of the better ones getting rotated out. The scenario for this month was kind of difficult to show in a display. You're better off just going and reading the actual PDF file that they have on the website. Basically, you're going to be building 2 fleets. One fleet is a Rebel fleet, one fleet is a Borg fleet. You get all sorts of bonuses for non-Borg ships in the Rebel fleet, and all sorts of bonuses for Borg ships in the Borg fleet. You also get a pile of mission tokens, which you can use for various things depending on which fleet you're running. And the idea is basically, each round you're going to be set up to either play your Borg fleet or your Rebel fleet. Your opponent's going to play the opposite, and it's a last man standing type thing. But basically, Rebel fleets get bonuses for non-Borg cards. So every non-Borg upgrade you throw in there costs a little bit less, I believe it ends up being. Same with the Borg ones. All the Borg cards that you put on Borg fleets end up costing you less. And I think there's no cross-faction penalty for putting non-Borg upgrades on Borg ships as well. So your Borg fleets are going to get 1 token per every ship. These mission tokens can be spent in place of Borg drone tokens to activate various Borg abilities. However, at the end of the game, each one of these tokens that you still have on your ship is worth an additional 8 points for the Borg. Each one of the Rebel ships is going to get 3 tokens. Each turn, each ship may spend 1 token, in order to re-roll one of your attack dice or to re-roll one of your defense dice, but only one per turn. And again, at the end of the game, the Rebel fleet is going to score 2 extra points for each of these that are still remaining on your ships. So while you may need those rerolls, you may want to keep them just for the bonus points. And like I said, the game runs to annihilation. When one side or the other is destroyed or time runs out, you're going to add up your points plus the bonus points you got from your mission tokens and figure out who the winner is. The next round, depending on win-loss ratios, the player who plays the Borg fleet, the player who plays the Rebel fleet may change. It may stay in the same. There's a little chart for that. And eventually you're going to end up playing both your Borg fleet and your Rebel fleet and get a chance at both sides. But there's a set of rules on how to decide who gets to fly which fleet. And both have their bonuses. I think the Borg fleets have a little bit of an advantage in this, but that's the way it should be. That's why they rotate out. But definitely an interesting scenario and something new and different. If you manage to win this month 2 OP event for Resistance is Futile, you're going to take home the assimilated Bird of Prey here. It's definitely an interesting ship. I went into detail on these in their own video, so definitely check it out. But has an interesting stat line. It's a little bit more powerful than a regular Bird of Prey. And all of these assimilated ships come with a assimilated version and a faction version. So there's a Klingon one as well as a Borg one. So definitely check that out if you're interested. Anyway, that's it for this video, and we'll see you in the next one.